And we're positive. We are positive on the Dow Jones Industrial Average, just now up 4 points, and looks like the S&P wants to go positive. Let's just take a look at a sector, because at the open, everything was down 2%, essentially, right across the board. The important thing, S&P, industrials, tech, materials, now all turning positive. Most of these were down 2 or 3%. A couple things I'm going to be watching today. The first thing is volatility, and that's the most important thing. In terms of what's driving the markets, that's what mattered yesterday. We were driven by technicals, not fundamentals, and volatility was the major issue. A lot of people had no protection far out of the money, and as we hit 2750, 2700, 2650, a lot of people reached for volatility and protection, and they charged a lot of money for it, and that's what drove the VIX up. So will the bid for volatility subside? Well, take a look. Already, the VIX is in backwardation. Essentially, the VIX front month contracts, very, very expensive compared to the back month contracts. That's very rare, but this is already coming down. We were in the 40s earlier. So yes, volatility is already starting to subside. Next thing is ETF flows. Remember this ocean of money that came in January, $55 billion just into stock ETFs. There's been some modest outflows in the first 3 or 4 days of February, about $12.5 billion. But financial ETFs have had inflows. Watch what the retail investor do. How will the retail investors react, particularly those who bought in the beginning of the year? And if you want an idea of what's the average price of the VIX, well, the average price for the VIX this year is about $22,770. Now, that is well above where we were yesterday. The close yesterday was 2,648. So we're 140. The average investor in the S&P 500 this year bought the VIX at 2770. Obviously, we're well below that. The question is, so the average investor is 4% underwater buying the VIX. How will they react in the next few days? That's what everybody's watching. More to watch as well. A couple of things, just margin calls, demand by brokers for traders to deposit additional money if their accounts drop. Well, we're at record levels there. That could be an issue. And finally, just the credit spreads. Are there stress or not? If the credit markets don't show any stress, it's more likely this was just a viable dip rather than the end of the bull market. If the stress spreads to credit, I think there's be a lot more concern. So far, I don't see it and I don't hear about it. Finally, just on the volatility products, you've heard a lot about this XIV. Jim's been talking about it. You're essentially betting on lower volatility. So volatility is down 5%. You're up 5%. If the volatility is up 5%, you're down 5%. Here's the big problem, folks. What happens when volatility goes up 115%? That's what happened yesterday. And that's why these products have problems and issues and why, as you heard, it's being liquidated today, essentially. BlackRock issued a statement on this yesterday. This is the biggest ETF provider in the world, saying these kinds of products, and particularly exchange-traded notes, need to be thought of in a very different way. They said inverse and leveraged exchange-traded products are not ETFs. They don't perform like ETFs under stress. BlackRock strongly supports a regulatory classification system that would label these ETFs differently to clarify for both regulators and investors the risks associated with those products. So the bottom line is a lot of issues around exchange traded funds in the open. Let's just talk about the open and what's going on, because here's the man who actually knows everything about the open and what's going on. Tom Farley, who joined us yesterday to talk about the close, joining us now to talk about the open. How did the open look, Tom?
It was smooth. As you were talking, Bob, I saw the major indices waffling between just slightly negative to slightly positive. And other than the additional media here this morning, it feels like any other morning.
Yeah, I think the important thing is that we were talking about a couple of years ago, that August 20th event, 2015, when we saw an enormous open down 1,000 points, some delays in the stocks. You made some changes in the last few years in the way the market opens, and things have gone very smoothly. Tell us about those changes and what you're doing to make sure the openings are smooth.
Yeah, we've made a lot of changes. We've had kind of several volatile days. You mentioned August, the Chinese valuation, August 15, and then Brexit in June of 16, again with the Trump election. That's the last time I remember an overnight session volatile like today. I think it's worth taking a step back, taking a deep breath, and acknowledging the Dow is up 40% since that night. Unemployment is down by 1%. GDP is up by 1%. So a moment of volatility like this and a pullback in price, quite frankly, it's to be expected. And I think as a group, we need to take a deep breath and realize we're going to be okay. Things are okay at this moment.
But going to the open, a lot of people have been concerned about the ability of the market to handle big, sudden moves. You made some changes after August 20th when there were some delays in the open to make sure there was a quick, efficient, orderly open. And from what I can see, you tell me, we've had big days like the Brexit. We've had big days like the Trump election. And the markets have opened smoothly ever since then, the changes you made.
Yeah, it was very smooth. And my colleagues at competitor exchanges deserve to be applauded as well for yesterday. I'll point out here at the New York Stock Exchange, we didn't have a single stock that entered a limit up, limit down state, which is a sign of perhaps aberrant trading, and not a single stock listed here on the New York Stock Exchange. So while the trading was volatile, it was orderly. And I expect that to continue today.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.